Hello and welcome back. In this lesson, we will be covering the ways that the OutSystems platform provides to developers so that they can write reusable UI. Now, when developing complex screens, there are architectural and work breakdown benefits in splitting work in more manageable blocks. And in OutSystems web development, these are called web blocks. Now, web blocks allow you to implement not just the UI, but also the underlying logic that moves the UI. To recap, what are the benefits of using blocks? First, you can use a chunk of UI design in several screens without repeating the code. This has advantages in maintainability, because when you fix something in one place, it gets fixed everywhere. And much like in the code, you can encapsulate and hide away the details of the inner workings of a certain block. So, how do we design a new web block? You create a web block exactly like you would create a screen. You place it on the UI flow and you design it by dragging any widgets inside. You can then use a web block by dragging it inside a screen where you want to instantiate that web block. In fact, you can have web blocks placed inside other web blocks. You just have to be careful because recursion is not supported. So if you have a web block A that's got a web block B, this web block B cannot have A again. Finally, it's important to note that these web blocks, they have their own scope and they cannot implicitly see anything on the scope of the screen or another web block where they're inserted. The way to get the needed context into a web block is, like you would do on a screen, to use input parameters. And once inside the web block, the behaviors and the ways that you implement them are very similar to screens. So you have local variables, you can have a preparation to do data fetch, exactly like you would do on a screen, and screen actions to carry out any activities associated with, say, links and buttons. It's important to note that when you refresh a web block, it will rerun its preparation prior to rebuilding its visual content. Now, if you notice, and in the screenshot, you have the preparation and the screen action associated with the block. And if you look at the list of things, you will notice that there are no output parameters. This begs the question, how can the screen that includes a block be made aware of any interaction that the user has with this block? The way to do this is via an asynchronous mechanism. And this asynchronous notification can be triggered via the notify action. So at any point where in a web block action you need to notify the parent, you just call this notify action. It's important to know that this action can only be executed inside a web block. When you're notifying, you can optionally send back a message that will give context to the parent screen. Please note that as soon as you place one notify call inside a web block, all the instances of this web block will require a onNotify destination action to be provided. So every single place where this block is being used, you will need to go there and select a screen action of that parent screen that will handle these notify calls. To better illustrate what's happening, here we have a diagram that illustrates the notify mechanic. From left to right, in the web block, someone presses the save button. This calls the web block action number 2. As we are executing it, you find a notify call. This will look into the screen where this block is instanced, and it's number 3, and find out what is the screen action that handles this notification. Upon finding this, it moves on to this screen action, that's number 4 in our diagram, and runs it in the screen. So therefore, the screen can respond to an event that happened inside the web block. We don't have the need for output parameters. As mentioned, the notify can be accompanied by one parameter called message, that's a text. And here we can see how the message can be passed about. So we press save, we go into the web block action, we notify sending back the message John, and upon catching this notify on the screen, we can use the action notify get message to retrieve in this particular case, the string John, and act accordingly. Only one point remains to be mentioned. When designing a weblog, you have access to a special widget called the placeholder. You can drag the placeholder into the body of your weblog, and therefore you mark an area that is meant to be designed later, wherever the weblog is actually instantiated. So you defer the HTML content of that section to the screen that then includes the weblog. So in the top screenshot, you can see the editor showing a My Placeholder placeholder. And in the bottom screenshot, you can see this block being used inside my screen, and the My Placeholder appears over there, and that section is editable. It works almost as if it was a hole inside my web block. And that's basically it for web blocks and UI reusability. In a nutshell, select the sections of your screens that you want to reuse, place them in a web block, place these web blocks into screens. If ever you need to notify the screen, use the notify action. And in the screen, if you want to get the message from the notification, use the get notify message action. And don't forget, if there's sections of your weblog that you want to implement later, use the placeholders. See you guys in the next lesson.